do we really need institutions like the EFCC, the Civil Defense Corps, and the FRSC when we have the police?
We need it, provided the financial support is there. But left to me, the EFCC, as presently considered today, I've said it before, Mangu is one of the best material. The same thing with Ilia. The same thing with some of their officers. I agree that maybe some few people. Yeah, and that one is in every profession. But if the support, like some of my policemen working there, some of them are living in Badagry, some of them are living in Ukorodu with one PR uniform. It is not the fault of the IG. There are many competing interests, but the actual financial support is not there. If the government increases tax now, you people will be shouting. Look at the way Buhari started. They are grumbling. And he's a fairly focused person, but his way as a military man is used to it. But as time goes on, you see things are going to change for better. It's just patience and support. Like a few days ago, I heard in the news that the vice president, who happened to be my law teacher, was saying that they have saved about 1.something trillion. They should make plan to release that money for ventures to assist the unemployed. But the funny thing with our people is that many of them, they believe only in stealing. They don't want to work, which is not good. And Buhari doesn't want that. That is the truth.
What gives you the most concern about the Nigeria of today?
Is the unemployment and insecurity. But with hard work, support for the government, and prayers, we will overcome all. I want everybody to be happy. We must all be up and coming, be prepared to work. You will see able-bodied people, they will sleep, they get up around 11 and begin to beg for money. Because of what? Bible say, knock, it shall be opened. Ask, you shall be given. Seek, you shall find. They didn't want to work. They didn't want to plant. They want to reap. They need some hard measures. But at times, we soften it to bring them nearer. If they give Buhari the support, the advice, and tell him this is the things will change for better. I say, human being, he has his own fault.
As a young prince growing up in Lagos, what are those things that you remember about Nigeria that fill you with nostalgia today?
Well, you see, in those days, many taxi drivers, if you forget something in the taxi, they take it to police station. If you see policemen, you see their standard of neatness. And even the chiefs, if I tell you something, you believe it. I've been praying to God since 1964 to become the Oba of Lagos. That was the day, I think July 12th, when the Oba Adile died. I was playing football here with some people. We saw motor coming in. They were bringing nice block. I helped them to carry it. I didn't know what happened. The next day, the zealous service said, pages are seen carrying nice block. My late cousin, KK Shomadi, wrote to them that he's a prince, so he's a descendant of so. He's not a page. And since that, you call me a page. Like now, I have been telling many people, there is one particular person, I don't want to name him. I brought him from England. He's very close to me. He's a member of the Lagos royal family. I wanted to train him the way Obo Yekun and nobody. They showed me many things. But I have told him, everything is not money, money. Me, I know how to work for money and get money.
Alailua, we thank you for your time, Kabis.
Thank you very much.
And that's our program View from the Top. We thank you for watching. Please join us next time when the program returns. But between now and then, do let's continue the conversation online at channelstv.com. And do follow me on Twitter at @modelesy. Thank you again for watching and see you next time. Let's leave you now with sights and sounds from the Palace of the Oba of Lagos.